We are officially on day three of the Beat the Algorithm Challenge. So I'm super excited to dive into this final topic with you because it kind of rounds out everything that we've been doing over the last couple of days. And if you haven't joined the challenge yet, just go to visionarymarketingcourse.com/challenge and you can get everything for free right there by signing up. So at this point, hopefully you have decided on what your algorithm-proof content is going to be. The second thing is that you've done an audit or an assessment of what type of content is actually working. I think, you know, one of the easiest ways to produce great content is to see where people are already gravitating, where their eyes are already going, and to quickly audit where have you gotten the most comments? Where have you gotten the most likes? And what's already working in your social media and marketing strategy? And then in yesterday's training, we talked about the Almanac of Relevance. This is something I cover in depth inside of the Marketing Mastery Intensive, which you can learn more about at visionarymarketingcourse.com. But the Almanac of Relevance is really where you've paired your product or service with a relevant or a timely event. So something that is going on in the conversation or in the mind of your dream client that you can kind of, we'll call it piggyback on, right? So now what do we do? We've got these three things in place. I'm talking on two screens right now, so I'm gonna be left and right. So in order to beat the algorithm and to round out these trainings that I've been teaching, what we want to do is make sure that we're not just shouting this message at people. Now you've crafted a really sturdy message. And instead of shouting and being like, hey, look what I have for sale. Buy from me, buy from me, buy from me, which is what so many brands and businesses do. And eventually we just ignore people who are shouting at us. Instead, what I want you to try from this training is the experiential expo. So again, this is another concept I teach in depth inside of the Marketing Mastery Intensive. So with the experiential expo, what you're doing is you are simply kindly and confidently inviting people into an experience with you, okay? Instead of shouting about your product and service, you're inviting them into an experience. So this could be something like a discovery call. It could be a training. It could be a freebie or a lead magnet that you invite them to enjoy. But this needs to be something that helps them to feel your brand, to feel some emotion associated with what you do, and to foster a connection or a relationship with you. Because if you have a client-based business, so much of it is based on relationships, okay? You could have the prettiest Instagram in the world, but if you don't know how to create a relationship and start that relationship using the experiential expo, you're missing the whole point of what it is to be in service to another human being, right? So experiential marketing is really like the last 10% of, you know, getting your word out there that most people aren't willing to do. Most people are willing to create content, write blogs. Most people are willing to, you know, send out that weekly email, but they're not willing to go that final 10%, which is looking at all these people you're talking to in your ecosystem and actually inviting them into an immersive experience with you, a free trial, a way that they can get to know you, a way that they can test drive your product or service. And I think why a lot of us avoid that is because we're actually worried about what people might think when they experience us. We're worried that our product or service is not good enough. It doesn't do what it says it's going to do. Right? And that's why we don't invite people in, because we're still building our confidence. We're still trying to reassure ourselves that we do have a remarkable change-making offer for somebody. So for those of you who are avoiding inviting people in, ask yourself, like, am I scared to showcase my product and service? And again, if the answer is yes, then work on improving your product, your offer first, and then get ready to implement the experiential expo. So right now, most of you are probably jumping from awareness. So people find out about what you do. And then after you keep bringing them up to speed, what I do, what I do, what I do, you try to pitch a product or service on them and you try to make the sale. But most people aren't ready to buy without a trial. So between awareness and selling, is free trial. Okay. So this is something that we need to be focusing on. This is just a simple concept called the consumer purchasing cycle in action. It starts with awareness of who you are. It ends with somebody actually trying out your services and referring what you do. But in the middle is going to be trial, is going to be somebody learning how they can actually benefit from your product or service. And most often that's best done through creating an immersive experience, giving them a sample of your work rather than trying to convince them that you're the right coach, you're the right yoga teacher, you're the right wellness practitioner. Try not to convince, instead give people a sample, a free trial, you guys. It's like when you go into Costco and you're not looking to buy cookies, but they gave you a free sample of cookies and then you walked out with cookies, right? You paid for those boxes of cookies. It's the same thing with service providers. We need to be giving samples. So not enough businesses are doing this. And to play up the examples from yesterday and the day before, if you're a family photographer and you want to be shooting outdoor birthday parties all summer long, outdoor first birthday parties, usually they have the cake smash where the kid smashes the cake. You need to be giving a sample of that. If you want to convert people from being aware that they can hire you for a COVID-friendly birthday to actually booking you, why not watch the people who are following your work and take their child's photo with permission and put it into a sample photo book for them and say, this is what we could create for the grandparents, for the aunts and uncles, for the cousins, because I know you're not going to be able to have that birthday party this year. Or maybe if you are a nutritionist, for example, and you help women to get fit before the summer and feel their best before summer, why not invite them into a 3-day, you know, vegan challenge or keto challenge or weight loss challenge, whatever you want to call it, get fit for summer challenge. Show them how quickly this process can work. Show them how good they can feel in just 3 days, and then bring them into your offer. Then get on a sales call with them. Give them a sample of your work. These mini experiences are enough to get people hooked for life. Yet many of us, many businesses, small businesses that I work with are just continuing to shout over social media. They're continuing to blast messages on deaf ears rather than inviting people into a sample. So I hope that this gives you some ideas that you can really think about how your dream clients can try you on for size. And if you do need any ideas, please reach out to me. I love chatting experiential marketing with you all. And like I said, we're going to be doing a deep dive on the Experiential Expo for an entire week inside of the Marketing Mastery Intensive, which starts Monday, May 31st. So if you're a small business owner who's struggling with slow and inconsistent growth, if you're ready to come up with a comprehensive marketing strategy once and for all, a strategy that allows you to feel ease, to know that you're bringing in new leads, new clients on a consistent basis, right? To actually know that you have a predictable outcome each month, then please head to visionarymarketingcourse.com and get yourself on the waitlist for that, because we've got some early bird specials for you. So that's it for today. I hope you have enjoyed this Beat the Algorithm Challenge. These are 3 lessons. You can go back to them anytime, that are going to help you stop worrying about the algorithm and start worrying about booking more clients. All right. So I will catch you guys very soon. And if you have any questions, please reach out.